Hello, my name is Rebecca and I'm a prevention education instructor for Greater Manchester Fire and Rescue Service. In this presentation, we will discuss the dangers of bonfires and fireworks, how to stay safe during the bonfire and Halloween period, stop, drop and roll in case your clothes catch fire, what antisocial behaviour is. This includes deliberate fires, hoax calls and attacks on firefighters. We will also look at the law and consequences of antisocial behaviour. We are going to watch a bonfire safety video. It shows Danny, who is 14, and an older group who are around 16 years of age. This is a drama based on an actual incident that occurred. The aim of the video is to demonstrate numerous dangers and promote areas of concern.
Going on.
Okay, Danny, my name's Dave. I'm one of the doctors here. I'm going to be looking after you. We don't want you to worry. What we're going to do is we're just going to put an oxygen mask on and we're going to cut this jumper off and attach some leads. Okay, and then we're going to give you something for the pain. Okay, you might feel this little cool on your skin, Danny. Don't be worried.
Pop this mask over your face, Danny. Keep it nice and cool.
What happened?
See you later, Mum.
Bye, love. Be careful.
I will.
Mum, why does he want to come to the park with us and watch the fireworks?
He's a big lad now, Liv. He's at that age where he wants to be with his friends. He's sensible and they're a good bunch. But don't worry, we'll have a good time too.
Go on, lad. Get him there.
What's going on there?
Go ahead, Emma.
Ops 4 from Mike 1251. The client has been hit by a firework.
What's going on?
Windscreen has been damaged and is now unable to proceed to incident. Request another appliance to be dispatched.
So where's the lads, maybe 16, 17? I only caught a glimpse of
them. Just because it's November the 5th, some of them think they can do what they want. And guess what, they can't. The CCTV around here is fantastic. We'll catch them.
That's really stupid, that. You could have been on the way to save someone's life.
I know, yeah.
Anyway, let's go to the park. We can cut through the woods.
Where are we going?
Hey.
Hey, lad. Lad.
Yeah.
Okay, Danny, you just go up a little bit. Let's switch him over onto the oxygen.
Danny, I'm
just going to
cut your top off okay, so
we can
have a little look at you and see if you've got any burns on your chest.
They've said you're going to need skin grafts. It's really going to help with the scarring.
Wish it never happened.
It's okay, love.
Thank you.
I will now discuss some of the points from this film. Fireworks. Fireworks are explosives and injure hundreds of people every year. Lots of people injured by fireworks are children aged 14 years and younger, the same age as you and your friends. Both bonfires and fireworks reach extremely hot temperatures. They can burn up to 2,000 degrees. That's 8 times hotter than your ovens at home. It only takes a second for fireworks to burn skin. Bonfires can easily get out of control and be difficult to put out. Both bonfire and firework incidents can result in life-changing injuries, as seen in the video. The injuries Danny sustained can take months and years of hospital treatment. Serious burns can leave lasting scars. Danny's type of injury could impact his vision. We don't want this to happen to you. Please attend organised public displays. These are safer and more spectacular. Greater Manchester Fire and Rescue Services advice is to attend an organised event. But if you are going to have fireworks and bonfires in the garden, here are some safety advice for you and your adults to follow. So please listen carefully. Please always follow the firework code. Only adults, 18 plus, should light bonfires and fireworks. They should check the instructions on each firework before lighting them. A minimum safe distance for a bonfire is 5 metres. That's a car's length away. For fireworks, it'll say on the fireworks themselves. Usually it's 8 metres or 25 metres depending on the firework. 25 metres is the length of 3 double-decker buses. This is for your own safety and to avoid injuries. Always keep a few buckets of water and or a hose pipe nearby. Never return to a firework once it has been lit. Never throw fireworks or aerosols onto a bonfire. Aerosol cans contain liquid made up of different chemicals. If the aerosol comes into contact with the fire, then it will heat the liquid in the can, causing it to expand and then in some cases explode. This can be unpredictable. You won't know which direction it will go and it can travel for some distance, injuring anyone in its path. Check that no animals are hiding in the bonfire before lighting it. Keep pets indoors. Fireworks particularly can be frightening and distressing for animals. Never put fireworks in pockets and never throw them. Please inform your adults of these safety measures and ask them to read and follow the firework code on our website. If your clothes catch fire, you should stop. Stop what you are doing and stay very still. Drop to the floor. Roll side to side until the flames are out. Here's some first aid advice for burns. Cool the burn with running cold tap water for 20 minutes. Cover with cling film or a sterile, non-fluffy dressing or cloth. Call for help for any burn larger than a 50 pence coin. 999 or 111. You should also think about Halloween outfits. Never wear Halloween outfits around fireworks, bonfires, or other naked flames, as the materials might be more likely to catch fire. Only buy Halloween outfits with a CE mark on them, as these are safer. If you are going trick-or-treating, never go alone. Only trick-or-treat at houses that are decorated. On the increase at this time of year, unfortunately, is antisocial behaviour. Antisocial behaviour is behaviour which causes or is likely to cause harassment, alarm, or distress to another person. This can include deliberate fire setting, such as wheelie bins or skip fires, hoax calls, a telephone call made to trick or deceive someone, attacks on firefighters, causing noise and nuisance in a public place, and drinking alcohol on the streets. So what are the laws regarding bonfires and fireworks? Remember, it is against the law to deliberately start fires, buy or own fireworks under the age of 18, set off or throw fireworks in a public place, set off fireworks between 11 p.m. and 7 a.m. except on bonfire night, New Year's Eve, Diwali and Chinese New Year. Attack emergency service workers. Don't be pressured by others like Danny was to do anything you are not comfortable with. Walk away and inform an adult. Now we are going to explain why hoax calls are dangerous to the fire service and other emergency responders. Whilst firefighters are at their station, they receive a call out for an incident. This is actually a hoax call, but they are not aware of this until they arrive. Whilst attending the hoax call, they receive another call to a different address, which is a real fire. This means they have a longer distance to travel to reach the actual fire, which puts people's lives at risk. Ultimately, we cannot be in two places at once. This is the same if anyone makes a hoax call to the emergency services. You may not realise that all 999 hoax calls are traced and recorded. Hoax calls and antisocial behaviour information is given to the police for further action. Firefighters can risk their lives attending every incident. This includes hoax calls. When our firefighters are attending a hoax call, they cannot be at a real emergency. Next time, it could be your family who need our help. So think before making a hoax call. Attacks on firefighters and fire appliances are a type of antisocial behaviour. This could include verbal or physical abuse, objects being thrown at a person or a fire appliance. This sadly happens more during the Halloween and bonfire season. Every fire engine has CCTV which films everything that happens. It is never acceptable to attack firefighters. They are there to help you and keep everyone safe. And this is the same for any other emergency service worker. Consequences. Antisocial behaviour is serious and could impact your future. If you end up with a criminal record, it will limit your career and employment prospects, and some countries won't allow you to visit. You could receive a £5,000 fine or 6 months in prison. You can face up to 2 years in prison for attacking firefighters. If you put someone's life in danger by starting a fire, you could be sentenced to life in prison. We work closely with the police and will press charges against any antisocial behaviour. Our fire investigation team are dedicated to finding those who are deliberately starting fires. Always think about the consequences of your actions. Remember, never put yourselves in situations that may be dangerous. Think about the consequences of what could happen and how you and others may be affected. Have a safe time during Halloween and bonfire season. Please attend an organised event. For more information, click the link on the screen or visit Greater Manchester Fire and Rescue Services website. Thank you for watching.